No wonder these plants in the Adelaide Conservatory look so lush. There's an automatic watering system that provides them with as much water as they need. But more importantly, there's a fogging system that maintains very high humidity around their leaves all the time. And that means that they'd lose very little water. The plants in our gardens are nowhere near as fortunate as that. Australia's sunny skies and often very low humidity means that our plants lose large amounts of water. And what rain doesn't replace, we must provide through our sprinklers. The question is, how much water do we need to provide? Or put the other way around, in a country where water is very expensive and there's not that much of it, how little do we need to provide to just maintain our plants in the condition that we would like them to be in?
Think of the soil under your garden as a large reservoir of water. Some of the reservoir space is taken up with solid particles of soil, but between them are holes, called pores, that are filled either with air or water. When rain falls, or when we water our garden, the water moves down through these pores. A rain shower giving 5 millimetres of water will, on average, wet the soil to a depth of about 20 millimetres.
Most of the roots of typical garden plants are within the top 500 millimetres of the soil, so that's where we need to put our water. Now, it would take about 125 millimetres of water to percolate down to about that depth. To get the most out of the water that you're putting onto your garden, you must know the rate at which your sprinklers are delivering that water. Now, for a lawn like this, the simplest way of getting that rate is to use a can test. You can see here we've got a grid pattern of cans all over this lawn here. They can be any shape and size of can as long as they've got straight sides. What we're going to do is to turn the sprinklers on here for an hour and measure the depth of water that is put into each of these cans. Well, the sprinklers have been on for an hour now. All we need to do now is to measure the depth of water in each of the cans. Now, I've done this before, and I know that these sprinklers deliver about 20 millimetres of water each hour. Now, if I want to moisten this soil to a depth of 500 millimetres, I need about 125 millimetres of water. So these sprinklers need to go on for about 6 hours to fill up that soil to that depth. That amount of water will keep this lawn going for 3 to 4 weeks in a typical Adelaide summer. In most parts of Australia, water is becoming more expensive and we're paying for every drop we use. That's a very good incentive for keeping use to a minimum. The most powerful way of reducing water consumption in your garden is to delay watering until the plants are wilted, like this one here. What happens then is that the plant can't get water from the soil, or it can't get very much, and so it sort of shuts up shop for a while. Of course, it grows more slowly, but at least it uses a lot less water than it would otherwise if you kept the soil very moist. Now, this sort of strategy is not for you if you want a lush garden. The second most powerful way of reducing water consumption in a garden is to have a thick mulch on the surface of the soil. A mulch such as this here can reduce evaporation of water from the soil by about 70%. If we dig down here, we can see that the soil is still reasonably moist, even though this is the middle of the summer. So the important points to remember are these. Know how much water you're putting onto the soil. Fill up that reservoir to its total content, and then let the plants dry it down to as far as you dare go. And of course, in the garden beds, have a good mulch right over them.